Feliz domingo por la mañana, Pastors Jose and Patricia. We want to welcome you to New Beginnings Church of the Big Bend, where we honor God, love families, serve others, and pursue excellence. Bienvenidos a la iglesia de Nuevo Comienzo. So we want to welcome all our NBC family, all the visitors, all of you joining us by audio and video. Yes. Amen. Prepare yourselves to receive what God has for you. And He always has something for you. If you don't think so, you're not going to receive anything. But if you prepare yourself, I'm hungry, I'm thirsty for more of Him, He's going to bless you. Amen. Yeah. So get ready for a blessing. Amen. Yeah. He wants to bless you, encourage you, change you, and He wants to correct you. We're going to be talking about remaining in God's joy. Yeah. It is joy unspeakable and full of glory. Amen. I love that song. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Don't leave as you came. He's not finished with you. He has great plans for you. Make yourself available for Him to use. He doesn't call the qualified. He qualifies the call. Mm-hmm. And He's called every one of us. Amen. See yourself that way. You're so special. He calls you. And He anointed you to do and fulfill whatever He called you to do. If you don't see yourself that way, it's time that you do. Mm-hmm. And start growing in the things of God. Start growing in the Word. Get feeding on the Word. And stepping out in faith. Amen. Hallelujah. Yeah. I don't know about you, but I'm blessed already. Before we get too busy here, I've got some nuggets. Welcome. There you go. Let's make grab your Bibles and make this declaration together. Yeah. Amen. This is my Bible. I am what it says I am. I have what it says I have. I can do what it says I can do. Today, I'll be taught the Word of God. I boldly confess. My mind is alert. My spirit is receptive. And I'll never be the same. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. I like that. I love that. Amen. Let me read a couple of nuggets to you before we get started. And it says, remain in God's joy. There is joy and calmness in life. To life, living in gratitude. Gratitude means thankfulness, mm-hmm. counting your blessings, yes. Noticing simple pleasures, mm-hmm. and acknowledging everything that you receive. It means learning to live your life as if everything were a miracle. Mm-hmm. We're being aware of contagious basis on how much we've given. Gratitude shifts your focus from what your life lacks to an abundance of what is already present.
Yes.
Amen. He wants to bless you. Giving thanks makes people happier, more resilient. Uh-huh. It strengthens relationships, it improves health, and it reduces stress. I'm going to read you another list here in a few minutes. It says, a thankful heart opens your eyes to a multitude of blessings that continually surround you. Mm-hmm. And He wants to bless you. Yes. The only thing that stops Him from blessing you is me. I got to get myself right. Yeah. Amen. Praise God. The first thoughts in the morning should be this. On a daily basis should be this. Thank you, Lord.
Yes.
Thank you. Yeah. And remain in His joy.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Man. Let me give you a few. We're going to be talking about joy. Joy acronym is Jesus owns you. You don't own yourself. He bought you. Amen. And He paid a price. He didn't have to. But we owe a price that we cannot pay. Mm-hmm. Amen. But He paid and He bought us back.
Yes.
The Father sent Him. He came. He was sacrificed. And He bought us back.
Yes.
And He defeated the enemy. So now, soldier of God, child of God, start pressing on and doing for Him. Amen.
Yes.
But listen to this. Be joyful and smile. 10 reasons we should make an effort to smile on a daily basis.
Wow.
If you want a copy, I'll give it to you at the end here. But be joyful. Smile makes you more attractive. Smile. Smiling relieves stress. Some of us need to do this. Get rid of that stress. Smiling elevates your mood.
Yes,
amen. I mean, that is great. I'd rather smile than frown, you know. Some of us need to give our frown a break. Amen. Smiling is contagious. You know, you go smiling and people see you and they start smiling. They say, why am I smiling?
Nah.
Amen. That is good. You know, put a smile on and bless somebody with a smile. Yeah. Amen. Smiling boosts your immune system.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Good medicine. We're going to be talking about those scriptures in a few minutes. Smiling lowers your blood pressure.
Mm.
Get it down. You know, you're full of that bad news and it brings your blood pressure up, you know.
Mm.
Smiling lowers your blood pressure. Smiling boosts your immune system. Mm-hmm. All this is good. God gave us all these things. Uh-huh. Amen. And we've totally gone against these things. Smiling mm-hmm. makes us feel good. Amen. These are just quick things here. Smiling makes you look younger. Really? Smile, boy.
All right.
Keep a smile on you. Smiling makes you seem successful. And smiling helps you stay positive. Amen. Just some quick little nuggets for you. Amen. Mm-hmm. So let's remember these things. Mm-hmm. I shared with the church family here a few minutes ago, but those of you who are joining us by audio and video, religion says this. This is the way. And that's what people, that's what man says. You know, this is the way. If you want to join us, this is the way it's going to be. Mm. But Jesus says, I am the only way.
Yeah, yeah.
Amen. So we want to go by Jesus' way.
Yes.
What the Word of God says, Jesus says, I am the only way. No one goes to the Father except through me.
Uh-huh.
Amen. So regardless of what the world says, whose way they go, mm-hmm. we're going God's way. Amen.
Yeah.
And I shared with the family a few minutes ago, says, you're never fully dressed until you put a smile on. Put a smile on, amen.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you can have the most beautiful dress, you can have the most beautiful suit, and you're looking great. But you got a frown on.
Yeah.
Amen. You're not fully dressed yet. Mm-hmm. Put a smile on. Man, that all tops right. it off, amen. So
yeah.
praise God. That was free, amen. So just receive that. Be joyful. The joy of the Lord is your strength.
Uh-huh.
Here we go. Let me see some nuggets here, Carmen. It says, happy new month of October. It's a new beginning, a new start, a new mindset, a new focus, a
yes.
new intentions, and
new results.
Amen.
Yes.
So praise God, man. Be positive
yeah.
about this. Don't be saying, oh man, we're almost to the end of the year. But you know what? You started the year with a blast. I shared with the church family a few minutes ago. Listen to this. I read them this. It says start. The start of 2022. But we can do this on a daily basis.
Yes, yes.
Start means start. Stop all distractions.
Mm-hmm.
Take inventory of your life.
Mm-hmm.
Act in faith. Renew your mind
mm-hmm.
on a constantly as often as you have to, and trust God, and you press on a daily basis. Amen. So that's what we do. We start a year with a blast and we end it with a blast. Amen. So
yeah.
if you're not doing that, it's time we start.
Yes.
Amen. So let's get going. Praise God.
Mm-hmm.
Remain in God's joy.
Yes.
Woo! Here's what you can do, and you can write this down. Have a Jesus joyful day. Have a Jesus joy filled day.
Yes.
Amen. Man, praise God. Encouraging all who are facing cares, problems, struggles, difficult situations to realize that you can still have the joy of the Lord no matter what you may be facing.
That's it.
Regardless of the situations, you know, those things don't make me.
Mm-hmm.
What makes me is Him. Amen. I have Jesus. I wear Him.
Yes.
Amen. Remember Jesus. All these things. He came. He knew from the time He came that He was going to be sacrificed.
Mm-hmm.
But He served each and every day.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Joy of the Lord was His thing.
Yes.
Amen. Praise God. He kept pressing on. I mean, we are great Bible heroes, examples. You know, David and Goliath. You know, David said, when he saw the giant, I said, who is this uncircumcised Philistine?
Mm-hmm.
Cursed my God.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, he grabs the stones. He says, I'll fight him. He knew mm-hmm. God was backing him. And he said, he grabbed some stones and he ran to go meet the giant. And the giant's laughing at him. That's what the world does. He laughs at
mm-hmm.
you. He said, who do you think you are?
Mm-hmm.
I'm a child of God. I can do all things through Christ
things.
Who strengthens me.
Amen.
Greater is He that's in me than he that's in the world. This is what you have to tell yourself, remind yourself,
amen.
Speak to yourself, amen. Praise
yes.
God.
Yes.
Stay away from distractions. There's a lot of joy distractions out there for you. People will come and tell you, what is so good about this day? You know, hey, this is the day that God has made. Rejoice and be glad in it. You got to let them know. You know, when they give you a negative, you give them a positive. Amen. Share with them. Stay away from people that are taking away your joy in the Lord and trying to replace it with joy of the wrong source.
Amen.
You need to know when it's time to step aside. You need to know when it's time to leave, shut it off, or whatever, you know. Wrong things that will distract you. Pull away from your walk with God. That's what they're going to try to do on a daily basis. Enemy says, in John 10:10 says, the enemy, the devil, comes to steal, kill, and destroy. And the enemy uses people, just like Jesus uses people.
Yeah.
Amen. If you're not born again, then you're on the other side, and the enemy's going to use you. Well, I don't serve anyone. If you ain't serving God, you're serving the enemy.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Why is it so many believers lose their joy? We start our day, our jobs, our life, our walk, mm-hmm. always full of joy. And Psalm 118:24 says this, and we know this. This is the day the Lord has made. I, and you can put your name there, Hosea, will rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. That's your choice. And that's what the Word of God says. So be obedient to what the Word of God. Have faith in the Word of God. You know, you try to figure out and reason things out before you have faith in Him. Just trust Him and have faith and step out. This is the day the Lord has made. Rejoice and be glad in it. Keep going, Kermit.
Mm-hmm.
There we go. Oh, we'll get there. Hallelujah. And Nehemiah 8:10 says, in the lower part of it says, do not sorrow, for the joy of the Lord is your strength.
That's it.
Amen. How many of us need strength on a daily basis? Mm-hmm. We all do. I mean, if you just listen to the world, you listen to people, they'll pull you down.
Yeah.
And if you're not feeding on the Word of God and keeping yourself up, you're going to fall.
Yeah.
And you're just going to be like the world, and you're just going to fall back. Mm-hmm. You don't want to do that. So full with love, joy, and zeal. This is us, enthused with passion and eager to serve Him and be like Him.
Amen.
Amen. People are going to see you, and they see that smile, and it's going to be contagious. Mm-hmm. And it's just going to draw because they're curious. They want to know why you're so happy. Mm-hmm. You know, it's a lost world, bad news, and you're smiling. Mm-hmm. That can't be so. I mean, what are you high on? I said, I stay high on the Most High.
Yeah.
That's the best high you can get.
Yeah.
That's the best thing you can do. When we first come Christians, everything is joyful and great. But as time goes by, seems like we spring a leak. That's what they call a leaky Christian. Leaky Christians, we just drain ourselves. Mm-hmm. We lose all the joy. We lose all these things. And we start falling back and being just like the world. Sad, frowning, you know, being discouraged. Priorities change. We invite the world in. Words and actions change. Speaking wrong, negative words.
Yeah.
We do. We can do that easily. So we need to not allow ourselves to fall this way and do these things.
That's
and if you want to copy someone, be in Ephesians 5:1-2, in the Amplified, it talks about being imitators of God. So He's our Heavenly Father and our children. We are His children, and we're going to imitate Him. But we're going to imitate our God, be like Him.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Woo. Amen. Praise God. Psalm 18:21 says, death and life are in the power of the tongue. Mm-hmm. Death and life are in the words you speak. That's how powerful words are. God says, He sends His word out and goes and accomplishes what I send out to do. He said, and it never comes back to me void.
Mm-hmm.
It accomplished. So words are seeds that you're sowing on a daily basis. If you sow a seed, it's going to grow. So just put it on and don't release the negative things because it's going to grow back on you.
That's it.
So I don't want those things. Amen. It's time we learn these things because the truth is going to set us free from these and it's not going to have us anymore. So death and life are the power of the tongue, the words you speak. Good or bad or positive, negative. Leaky Christians speak bad, negative words. It opens the doors for the enemy to come in. And your joy is going to go back into being a frown.
Right.
Instead of a smile, you're going to have a frown, you know. Because now you got the world, you got all these cares, all these problems back on you. And He says, we're supposed to cast it on Him.
Yeah.
Why are you taking it back? I tell you many times, if when you go to the dumpster and dump all your trash, you never go back and take it back. Oh man, I dumped all my trash. I just want to take it back. No. You leave it there. When you go to the cross and you pray and you leave all these things there, you leave it there. You don't take it back. He says, cast it on me. Give it to me.
Amen.
Amen. So there are too many Christians who are just struggling through life.
Mm-hmm.
Born again believers living a defeated life.
Yeah.
Confessing bad words on our way to heaven, sadly, instead of joyfully. On our way to heaven joyfully. We should be on our way to heaven joyfully, shouting and singing victory in Jesus.
Yes.
Amen. When the enemy comes to accuse you of something, he's the accuser of the brethren. And he'll come and accuse you when he sees you moving up.
Yeah.
But you let him know.
Yes.
That's not me anymore. I don't live there anymore. You're knocking on the wrong door.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. I've shut that door. I've gave it to Jesus. And Jesus says he's dropped all the charges. So you can't hold that against me anymore.
That's it.
So quit living in the past. We talked about that last week. Yeah, come on. Man, I'm excited about you. God wants us to rejoice and be glad in our lives. Amen.
Yes.
Have it more abundantly.
Mm-hmm.
And John 10:10 said, we just talked about that. John 10:10 says, the first part says, the enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy.
Right.
But Jesus says, I've come that you might have life and have it more abundantly.
Yes.
Amen. More abundantly. There we go. Keep going, Carmen. Nehemiah 8:10. Joy of the Lord is your strength.
Mm-hmm.
And we need that strength. Amen.
Yes.
There we go. Once again, the joy of the Lord is your strength. Keep going. We got some good ones for you. All right. That's good.
Mm-hmm.
It says, taste and see that the Lord is good. Oh, that the joys of those who take refuge in Him. This translation says, oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed, happy, fortunate to be envied is the man who trusts and takes refuge in Him.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. Keep going. I like that. Psalms 37:4-5 says, delight yourself also in the Lord, and He shall give you the desires of your heart.
Mm-hmm.
Commit your ways to the Lord, trust in Him, and He shall bring it to pass. Mm-hmm. Amen. Praise God. Amen. You know, I'm going to trust Him. I'm going to trust Him with my life. Amen. He gave me this life, and now I'm going to give it back to Him. I'm going to change my priorities, and I'm going to start serving Him first. And when I do that, I'm going to commit my ways to Him. I'm going to trust Him, and He's going to bring all these things to pass. Amen.
Woo.
Praise God. Thank you, Lord. The New King James says this, delight yourself also in the Lord, and He shall give you the desires of your heart. Amen. Amen. I'm excited. How about you? Here we go. Just where we are right now. Proverbs 17:22 says, a cheerful heart is good medicine, but a broken spirit saps a person's strength. We just read you a few things right here. Amen. This is good medicine. A smile, joy, brings, man, it just perks up your immune system. Amen. Makes you feel good. It's good medicine. But a broken spirit, that sadness, all these other things, it's just going to sap your strength.
Mm-hmm.
Why are you so down? Why are you so down and out, you know?
Mm-hmm.
You need to cheer up with Him, you know.
Amen.
Give yourself a Jesus lift, amen.
Mm-hmm.
Give your face a smile, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
This translation says, a cheerful, happy, joyful heart is good medicine. But a broken spirit saps a person's strength. Every morning when you wake up, just declare, this is the day the Lord has made. I'm going to rejoice and be glad in.
Yes.
Amen. Spend time with Him. Put Him first. And know, regardless of what's facing you, you have been with Him.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Whatever devil, whatever giant is waiting on you, you better look out. Because greater is He that's in me than he that's in the world. And I am ready for whatever's coming out there.
Yeah.
Because if you don't spend time with Him, that world's going to eat you up. In a heartbeat, amen.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. Decide to be joyful, happy, and smile right where you are. It says here, bloom, blossom where God plants you. Bloom, blossom wherever God has you.
Amen.
I mean, you find out all these Bible heroes, a lot of them weren't where they wanted to be.
Mm-hmm.
But still, they served God.
Yeah.
And God blossomed them.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. God is going to bless you. God is going to promote you. Wherever you happen to be. You know, I share with you many of these little flowers, these little seeds. It falls in the cracks, it falls in the roofs, it falls on trees, it falls everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
And it grows a beautiful plant.
Yeah.
And guess what? These little plants, regardless of where they are, they blossom so beautiful. Yeah. Beautiful flowers. Mm-hmm. Even these weeds that I go and chop all the time, they have beautiful flowers. But still, I got to chop them down, you know. But it doesn't matter, you know. They don't complain and talk about, well, you know, this is not where I want to be, Lord. I want to be over there. I want to be over here. I want to be with that bunch over there.
Yeah.
No, they just go blossom because you know what?
Right.
The greater one is with them.
Yes.
The greater one is mm-hmm. with them, and they have the joy of the Lord wherever they happen to be. And they're going to do what God created them to do.
Yes.
And you know, when you find, when we accept Him, we have the greater one in us.
Mm-hmm.
And we should be the happiest people on earth.
We should be. Yes.
Believers should be the happiest people
yes.
on earth. Why? Because we know Him and we have
yes.
Him.
Yes.
And we can do all things through
all
Christ.
Things.
So don't let the doom and gloom of this world sap you and take you down, or people, or really He uses you to try to distract you.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Woo!
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Make a firm decision to enjoy your walk, your journey. When you do, you will begin to experience an abundance
yeah.
of joy and feel like that Jesus died to give you. He died. God sacrificed His Son to give
Amen.
You. This life, amen. So you know what? If I'm gonna live for Him, I'm gonna enjoy. Amen. Enjoy it. Praise God. You know, when I was in the world doing and taking whatever illegal things I took, man, I was having fun.
Mm.
And then we turn ourselves around and come to Christ, and we the saddest people around. Nobody wants to join you. We should be the happiest people. Amen. I'm delivered, man. I'm set free. Thank you, Lord. And enjoy your walk. Amen. Enjoy your walk. Praise God.
Woo.
Psalms 100. Let's read that again. We read it so many times, but you know, we use the word of God. And if you turn to Psalms 100, let's read it. And you can read this on a daily basis.
Mm-hmm.
Are you there?
Psalms 100.
Psalms 100. It says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Are you there? All of us, make a joyful noise. Serve the Lord with sadness.
Gladness.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Gladness.
Gladness. Come before His presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, He is God. It is He that made us and not we ourselves.
That's it.
We are His people and the sheep of His pasture. You know, some of us still can't get it. He's our God. We're His people.
Mm-hmm.
We're His children. You know, so quit being so sad. Says verse 4 says, enter His gates with thanksgiving, into His courts with praise.
Uh-huh.
Be thankful unto Him and bless His name, for the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting,
mm-hmm.
and His truth endureth to all generations.
Yes.
Man, the word of God is great.
Yes, it is.
Amen. The word of God is great. Never outdated. It's always good.
Mm-hmm.
There we go. Thank you, Carter. Keep going. We got some good things. Here we go. Don't let the devil steal your joy. Wow. You never seen the devil? Well, sometimes some of these people you meet are full of the devil. And they go distract you. And they go say things. And don't give them the day. Don't give them the time. And don't listen to it. You know, say, excuse me, but I have to go. I got things to do.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have time to hear those things. Amen. Mm-hmm. Especially when you know it's going to sap you and distract you. It says, I don't need to hear that. Keep going. Man, these are good.
Mm-hmm.
Don't let anything or anyone steal your joy.
Yeah,
I'm telling you, on a daily basis,
mm-hmm.
people are going to try to steal your joy.
Oh,
they want you to be sad.
Oh,
they don't want you to be glad. It's always about who you please. Who are you serving? Are you serving God? Are you being a God pleaser? Or are you being a man pleaser?
Yeah.
Because if you're being a man pleaser, you're always going to be sad.
Hmm.
Because they want to make sure they're sad, so they want you to be sad.
Yeah.
They're down and out, so they want you to be down and out.
Right.
Keep going, come on. Here we go. Separate yourselves from blessing blockers.
Mm.
Or you could say joy blockers.
Yeah.
They purposely distract you with sin, drama, and fear because They can't stand to see you happy.
That's it.
I'm sad.
It's so true.
This is so true. And the next one, keep going. The best way to be happy is to turn the negatives into a positive. Don't let anyone steal your joy, and be thankful for what you have and whose you are. I'll just throw that in there. Know whose you are, and who you are, and what you can do through Him. Amen. And these things, don't let these things distract you. One more. There we go. Don't let the past steal your present. We talked about this last week. We talked about the past, the present, and the future. But don't let the past steal your present. Because the enemy, people, and people you know, families, they're going to try to do this.
Oh, yeah.
And the enemy is going to use anyone that allows themselves. And they're going to try to pull you down, take you down. Amen. Don't let it keep going. Here we go. Be happy. It drives people crazy. You can write this down. Be happy. Be joyful. It drives people crazy. Because they don't want to do it. Because they won't do it.
Yeah.
Because they're bound in what they're doing. They're pleasing the world. They're pleasing people.
Yeah.
And you're going to drive them crazy. It's just going to drive them crazy. People crazy. Woo. Hallelujah. Joy is not just a happy feeling based on circumstances or the things we possess. It is an unshakable stability in our inner man, our spirit. It is a joy that ranges from a calm joy to an extreme joy. Amen. And of course, we see Jeremiah 10, it says, the joy of the Lord is our strength. Most people spend most of their time uptight and upset because their joy, their happiness is based entirely on circumstances. Wrong job, wrong career, wrong relationship, wrong friends, wrong place. And man, you can base all that. And you say, man, I just don't want to be here. And most people don't want to be here and take themselves out. This is not what God wants you to do. God called you to do for Him and serve Him.
Amen.
And to be a winner, not to be a loser.
That's it.
If it's not happening this way, it's because you got to dethrone yourself and put Him on the throne. Put Him on the throne and start living for Him. And all these things are going to change. They will. The Word of God says so. But you got to start living what the Word of God says. Amen?
Amen.
People get happy and joyful when things are going their way. When they have lots of money in the bank. When it's Friday, when it's a holiday, when it's vacation time, when it's just time off. I got another acronym for TGIF. You know, everybody knows TGIF. Thank God it's time. Weekend, you know, hey, hallelujah. TGIF is thank God I'm forgiven. Thank God I'm forgiven. And you can say that on a daily basis. It's got nothing to do with a Friday. It's got to do with the blood of Jesus.
Right.
It's got to do with Him sacrifice.
Yeah.
Amen. Thank God I'm forgiven.
Yes.
Every one of us. But have you accepted Him as your Lord and Savior? If you haven't, this is the day. This is the day. All you got to do is just change and say, confess Him and take a step in the right way. Amen. Just like the prodigal son. He ran, but you know, one day he says, I can do better at Father's house. So it's time for you to come home. Turn around from what you're doing. The wrong ways, the wrong things.
Yes.
And turn around and come back to Father. Amen.
Yes.
All you have to do is just confess Him as your Lord and Savior.
Yes.
Woo! These things account for only a small part of our lives. The major time, people are sad, discouraged, and upset.
Mm-hmm.
You even believe us. If you're not growing, it's because you're not getting in the Word.
Mm-hmm.
Christianity is relationship.
Mm-hmm.
When you have a relationship with the Father, you're going to grow. Amen? And you get in the Word and you study the Word because that truth is going to set you free.
Mm-hmm.
I know what the word says now. So I'm going to confess what the word of God says. When you confess the word, it's going to set you free from all these mindsets, from all these bondages, from all these distractions.
Yes.
Amen. Now I can do all things through Christ. I'm confessing the word. The Bible even says, take authority. Submit yourself to God.
Yeah.
Resist the devil and he'll flee.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. So we're going to change friends. We're going to change things. And we're going to change that frown to a smile.
Yes.
And all this weight is going to come off. Amen.
Yeah. Ooh,
come on now. As we grow spiritually and our relationship with God grows, we grow in his word and it sets us free from bondages, from distractions.
Yeah.
We are free from the world and negative mindsets and traditions.
Mm-hmm.
Magnifying him and not the problems. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. I'm no longer magnifying that problem.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. The problems are not holding me down anymore. I'm magnifying God.
Amen.
The Bible says he's God on the mountain and he's God in the valley.
Mm-hmm.
So no matter how low you go, he's still with you. He says, I never leave you nor forsake you.
Thank you.
Amen. When you know these things,
mm-hmm.
you know you're going to have victory. Thank you, Lord. Build yourself up. Strengthen yourself. Oh, praise God. Thank you, Lord. Priorities change. Him first. I can do all things through Christ. We are joyful even when things are not going our way.
Mm-hmm.
Even when things are going bad. Even when bad things are happening all around you. Still, you know, hey, in the last days, it's going to get worse.
Yeah.
So it's time for us to get rooted and grounded more and more on him. So we know that we're not.
Thank you, Lord.
Anyway, thank you, Lord, for helping us.
Yes.
To choosing you.
Yes.
And taking ourselves off and putting you in the right place.
That's it.
That's all we need to do. Make the right choices.
Yes.
Make the right things. But you know, there's a lot of distractions, and the world wants you to choose their ways.
Yes.
Remain in God's joy.
Mm-hmm.
Joy is results of knowing who we are and whose we are. It's very, very, very easy. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Leviticus 11:45 says, I, the Lord, brought you out of Egypt so that you could be my special people and I could be your God. I am holy, so you must be holy too. You know, after he delivered them from Egypt,
mm-hmm.
you know, they ran into a little trouble. And he fed them and all these things and still said, well, we want to go back. Some of us, the enemy wants to pull you back.
Mm-hmm.
You were fine when you were in sin, but you got away from it.
Mm-hmm.
And if you don't renew yourself, your mind with the word God, he's going to want to pull you back.
Yeah.
Comes to steal, kill, and destroy. And we got to keep ourselves forward up to the top, to overflow. If not, we let ourselves go. And he's going to draw you back. Full-time devil. A part-time Christian, no match for a full-time devil.
That's it.
So don't be a part-time Christian only.
Mm-hmm.
Be full-time. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
They heard of God, chose them, loved them, and delivered them from slavery. They learned how to give them. He learned that he gave them the promised land. They learned that their purpose was as a people in this world. Amen. Keep going, Carmen. Hallelujah. Don't let your smile change the world. Or let your smile change the world. Don't let the world change your smile. Because they're going to do this on a daily basis.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Amen. Ooh, hallelujah.
That's it.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Give me another one. That's some good ones for you. Don't let anyone ever dull your sparkle.
Mm-hmm.
Remember, you are the light of the world. Amen. You've got that spark in you. Don't let that spark go out. Amen. Just keep it lit up.
Yes.
Amen. Always keep that fire going. Don't never let it go out.
That's it.
But it says, don't let anyone or the world or anyone ever dull your sparkle. They're going to see it. And it's what's going to attract them. You know, everywhere you go, you're the light of the world. And everywhere, every dark place you go to in the world, you bring light.
Mm-hmm.
You're the closest thing to a Bible.
Mm-hmm.
They'll be around.
Definitely.
And they see the light. Amen. So That's how special you are. Yeah. You're doing God's ministry. Mm-hmm. You're doing God's work everywhere you go. They see something different about you. Some of them may approach you and ask and tell you that. Some of them may not. But still, they're watching your words and they're watching your actions.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Woo.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Don't depend on other people's as the source of your happiness.
Oh, that's good.
Amen. Yes. Don't depend on other people's. I'm depending on you, Lord. He's going to bring you happiness. Amen. Mm-hmm. Regarding, you know, the Apostle Paul, man, a great man of God. But he's in prison most of his time. And he wrote 2/3 of the New Testament in prison. But prison never had him. Amen. Mm-hmm. But God, you know, he's a great man of God that got used. And even yes. in prison, you know, some of us would have been sad and doom and gloom, you know, and complaining to God. Paul and Silas got beat and put in prison. And instead of cursing God, they were magnifying God. They were yes. praising God. And God says, well, I got to go visit with him. And he's no respecter of persons. He'll come and do the same with you. He'll visit with you. Mm-hmm. Have you opened? He says, I knock, but are you answering?
Mm-hmm.
He'll come. And he visit with him. And he set him free. Amen. The jailer even got saved. His family got saved. Amen. People are going to get saved just by you being around them. Amen. Sharing with them. Praise God. It's a good thing. You can do all things through Christ. Keep going, come. Don't let the sadness of your past and the fear of your future ruin the happiness of your presence. This is what we talked about last week. Amen. But don't let the sadness of your past, and that's what distracts most people. Man, you don't know what I've been through. And then you get around people that want to give you advice that are in worse shape than you are.
Yeah.
And they won't tell you, same. You're trying to move on, and people come around and say, man, I know you, and I know your past. Mm-hmm. I know all about you.
Mm-hmm.
And they try to pull you down, take you down.
Mm-hmm.
But don't let that sadness of your past or the fear of your future hold you down. Amen.
Amen.
And it ruins, that'll ruin your present.
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm not going to let it. And you can stop it. Because all you have to do is confess His word and stand on the word. Amen. And those things are coming out of you and things are going to change.
Uh-huh.
Praise God.
Amen.
Too many people complain about how boring life is. They need to get a check. They need to check their priorities.
Mm-hmm.
They've lost their love for God. Mm-hmm. They open the doors for the enemy and other things. So get back in relationship with God.
Yes.
Life is not boring.
No, it's not.
Amen. All we need to do is check our priorities and renew our priorities on a daily basis. Keep them first on a daily basis, you know. And when you do this, things will change. Life is not boring when our priorities slip. Okay, we let our priorities slip. You will lose your joy if you're not willing to get out of your boat or out of your box. Allow the Holy Spirit to change, or lead us and change us. Amen. So let's remember this. Don't lose that love. Don't lose that love for God. Amen. And that joy for God. Amen. Because He is our strength. And we need Him on a daily basis. Amen. And when you're serving Him and you're joyfully serving Him, things are going to grow and things are going to change. Praise God. Simplify your life. Don't try to do too much. Uncomplicate your life. Same complicates your life so He can steal your joy. Keep us too busy to enjoy all God has given us. Amen. Remember the Mary and Martha? One of them says, what are you doing here? Why are you serving me? She didn't say this. I'm saying she was worshiping God. Came and joined Jesus and was ministering to Him. And the other one was too busy. But sometimes we're too busy. We ain't going to impress nobody. We're just going to hurt ourselves. Amen. But Martha says, why don't you have him come and help me? I need help. So no, you got your priorities wrong. Amen. Mary saw the Messiah there, saw the Master there, and came and worshiped him. And Martha was too busy being too busy. And sometimes we do that. We get ourselves too busy to even worship our God. Amen. Enjoy your relationship with God. Enjoy time with family and friends. Take time to laugh and crack a smile. Some of us really need this. Take time to enjoy life. Amen.
Amen.
So we're going to stop here. And for real, we need to be ourselves. That's what God wants us to do. Be yourself. Don't copy anybody. Just be the original God made you to be. Amen. That's it. What else we got, Carmen? That's it? Okay. Okay. Yeah. New creatures in Christ. Therefore, if anyone's in Christ, he's a new creation. The old is gone, the new is in. You see that beautiful, beautiful butterfly? I don't know if you know, but that came from a worm, from a cocoon. And now, look at the beautiful thing that came out of that.
Amen.
Amen. I mean, it's beautiful. The old is gone, the new is in.
Yes.
And you know, that's what we are. We're new in Him. Amen. I mean, this is great. And that's what 2 Corinthians talk about. 2 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new thing. The old is gone, the new is in.
Amen.
That's what we need to remember when people try to accuse us, or the enemy tries to accuse us, or use people to accuse us of our past,
right,
and what we've done, or what things, whatever happened. Don't worry about, hey, the old is gone, the new is in. I'm a new creation. We're talking about being born again.
Amen.
We had a spiritual birth.
Mm-hmm.
They see the same old you, but they don't see the new you.
That's it.
It was a spiritual rebirth. Amen.
Amen.
They don't see that, but our words and our actions are going to be different.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. So praise God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So remember, enjoy the abundant life Jesus died to give us.
Amen.
This beautiful, beautiful life, based on the decision you make, not on circumstances. Amen.
Amen.
Joy is God's gift to us, but some of us have never even opened this package. We need to receive it. God is just waiting for you to do so. Say amen. Praise God. He is the glory and the lifter of our heads. That's what the Bible says. Psalms 3:3 says, the Lord, you are a shield, a protector, and a wonder, and my wonderful God, my glory, who gives me courage and lifts up my head.
Amen.
Amen. So let's remember this. Amen. And start celebrating life instead of trying to endure life.
That's right.
That's what the world does. They just try to endure.
Mm.
We need to enjoy it as we go. But we need to change our priorities, and we need to start serving Him. Amen.
Yes.
So
amen.
Praise God. Did you get something?
Yeah.
It blessed me. I don't know about you. We need to decide to be happy, joyful people, children of God. Amen.
Amen.
Because we serve a powerful God. Amen.
Yes,
and greater is He that is in us than He that is in the world. Amen.
Yeah.
So praise God.
Praise
Father, we just thank you for this opportunity to get in your word and learn from your word. Father, help us to grow and go for you on a daily basis, Father, in Jesus' name. Some of you heard this, and it's time for you to come home. If you never accepted Jesus, you know, I tell you, now's the time. All you need to do is repent. Lord, I've sinned against you. Come into my life, be my Lord and Savior. And He's not going to reject you. He's going to receive you, regardless of what people say. He's going to receive you, and you need to start living for Him.
Yes.
Get yourself in a Bible, in a church where you can start serving Him, and start getting in the Word and studying the Word. Amen. So praise God. Thank you, Lord. And He's not going to accept you. He's not going to reject you. He's going to receive you. Amen.
Yeah.
So praise God.
Praise God.
Some of you that are hurting, we just pray for you. Bible says that body Jesus Christ with healed.
Yes.
Amen. So we're believing for your healing. No malfunctions in their body. We spirit of infirmity. We cast you out. We command you to go in Jesus' name. Father, we just thank you that they are healed. We call them well. We call them healed in Jesus' name.
Yes.
And we give you all the praise, glory, and honor, Lord, in Jesus' name. So with that, it's time to give. Those of you watching, listening,
mm-hmm.
we'd like to give. You can still do so. Go to our website, NBC Big Ben. .com, hit that donate button. If you're mailing it, NBC PO Box 252, Marfa, Texas 79843. And now you can give by Cash App at New Beginnings Church of the Big Bend. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. Amen. God loves you and we love you.